Coming up in this video, you're going to learn how to make lower third graphics inside of Photoshop for your next video. Stay tuned. This video is part two of this lower thirds series. Now, if you're starting to make videos for your church or for your business, you can make some custom graphics with some simple steps. Hang on to the end of this video because I've got a special bonus just for you. So if you are familiar with Photoshop, let's dive in and take a look at making some simple lower third graphics. Inside of Photoshop, I want to create a new document, and I'm going to go under the Film and Video tab and look for the 1920 by 1080 template size. If I don't see that preset, I can always expand and look and see if it's located a little bit further down in the list. But since I have it here, I'm just going to select that and click Create. The next thing that I want to do is turn on my guides, and I can hit Command semicolon on the keyboard or go up here to View, Show, and turn on guides. So I'm dropping in a screen grab from my other tutorial, and I'm going to use the same one just as a reference so I can see how my titles, how my graphics are going to look in a real world situation. Next, I'm going to go to the shape tool, click on that once, and then click on my canvas so I can get this dialog box. I'm going to type in 1920 as my width and then 230 for the height. Now, obviously, you can make this any size that you want, but I'm going to use this for this tutorial. I'll grab my arrow tool and then reposition the shape. Over here in the Appearance panel, I'm going to turn off the stroke and then select the fill. Inside the fill, I'm going to select the gradient tool, and then I want to make sure that I click on the foreground to transparent gradient box, which is typically in this second location. You can see that there are some other preset swatches available that you can quickly use, but for this one, we'll go ahead and modify this gradient just a little bit to fit our needs. So I want to change the angle of the gradient from, instead of going from the bottom to the top, I want it to go from left to right. So I'm going to change the angle of my gradient by just clicking and dragging this angle rotator tool here. And I'm also going to hold down the shift key at the same time. That way it will snap to zero. So let's make some changes with the color. And by just clicking twice on these little tabs, I can select any color that I want to. And I can do that for both sides. I can see that my gradient is going from this blue to this magenta pink color and then falling off. I can always adjust where my gradients will start and stop by moving these little sliders around. Next, let's place some text. So just grab my text tool, click once on the canvas, and then type in my text. I'll grab my arrow tool, and now I can go ahead and modify the font face and reposition my text. I'll hit Command T on the keyboard to transform, and I'll grab and drag out the corner handle just to scale this up a little bit. Once I have my text positioned and scaled up to where I want, I can always click the return key, or I can click on the checkbox here at the top to commit my changes. So I want to make sure that these are aligned. I'm going to grab my text layer here and hold down the shift key and click on the rectangle shape layer here. With my arrow tool still selected, I now have my alignment options. I'm going to reposition my text by holding down the shift key and dragging this over to this guide. I can use my arrow keys just to nudge it over because I want my text to line up right here on this guide. I'll select my rectangle shape layer, and then I'm going to drag down one more guide just to the top of this shape. Next, I'm going to grab my shape tool one more time, draw a quick rectangle here. I'm going to change the color to a fill. And then I'm going to add one more line of text. So to my text tool and type in my text. I'll repeat the process of moving the text to where I need it and making any changes to the rectangle shape. And then select both of my layers using the shift key to select both layers. And then again, with the arrow tool selected, I'm going to make sure that these are aligned in the middle. zooming in a little bit, I'm going to use the arrow keys and just nudge it over to where I can get this line of text and this line of text lined up on this guideline. That looks about right. Next, I want to go ahead and save my image. So I'm going to turn off my reference image and I'm going to turn off the background. Now I have a transparent background and we're going to save this image as a full screen graphic. So let's go up here to File, Save As, and I'm going to change the file format type to PNG. So let's give this a name. And as a pro tip, I like to put in the dimensions of my image into the file name. This way, whenever I go back to look at the images, I can see what they are in size before I even open them up. That can be a huge time saver. So let's click Save, and then I'm going to say OK for the PNG options. So let's continue to build out this canvas, and I'm going to select my top layer and hold down the Shift key and select my bottom layer, my reference layer. And next, I'm going to hit on my keyboard Command G to group, and that will put all of my layers inside of this folder. I can double click on the folder name and rename it as needed. So as we move on to our next lower third, again, I'm using another sample image just as a visual reference that I used from my previous tutorial and bringing it in here into Photoshop. I'm going to turn my guides back on and I'm going to grab my text tool and go ahead and drop in my titles. I'll make some changes by hitting Command T to transform and then reposition my titles. Next, I'm going to grab my shape tool and just draw a simple rectangle shape. Turn off the stroke and adjust the fill color. I can duplicate this shape by selecting the layer and hitting Command J to duplicate. I'll grab my arrow tool and I can reposition this bottom shape. I'll change the fill color. I'll organize my layers so that I have the shape and the text right next to each other. So with these two layers selected, I'll do the same thing as before with my arrow tool selected, make sure that they are aligned. For this bottom shape, I'm going to hit Command T to transform and just tighten this up a little bit. Next, I'm going over to my shape tool, but I'm going to click and hold down just for a moment, and I get this little flyout menu, and I'm going to select the triangle tool. Over here in this space, I'm just going to click and drag a triangle shape. And I'm going to set the fill to nothing, and this time I'm going to set the stroke to one of the colors that I used. I can also go down on this appearance menu and change in the size of the stroke. So let's see what 10 pixels look like. So that'll work for us. And now I'm going to duplicate this triangle layer by just hitting Command J one more time. And I'm going to change the fill color. Next, I'm going to change the stroke color, and I'll duplicate this one more time and change the stroke color again. Now let's reposition these, and I'm going to hit Command T one more time for my transform, scale this down a little bit, and if I move off to the side to one of the corners, my cursor changes and I can rotate while I still have this layer selected. So I'm going to make some minor adjustments to all of these shapes and get everything where I want it to be. Now that I have all of the elements here on my canvas, I do want to make another adjustment. So I'm going to select my bottom shape layer here, and holding the Shift key, I'm going to select my top layer. And next, I'm going to hit Command T and just do an overall rotation. And that looks about right. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the checkbox to commit my changes. Same thing as before, I want to turn off my reference layer and anything that I have below that I don't need, just leaving all of my elements that make up this lower third. Going to File, Save As, Format, PNG, and we'll save this out one more time. And click Save and OK.
Hey, if you're finding value in this video, tap that like button now and leave me a comment below. If this is the first time that we're meeting, my name is Jeff, and this is Always On Art, helping you design better together.
For this lower third, I've gone ahead and dropped in the elements that I need, and I've drawn a simple rectangle shape on this
lower third. I've also imported a texture image that I have downloaded, and I'll put a link to this image in the description box below. What I want to do is I want to put this texture inside of this shape. So I'm going to align this texture over my shape. And so I'm going to put my cursor right here between these two layers, my texture layer and my shape layer. Holding down the Option key and clicking once, now my texture layer is now masked to my shape layer. So as I move it around, you can see that it is constrained to the mask of this rectangle shape. I'll zoom in a little bit and make some adjustments to the placement. I will align my rectangle and my text layer by clicking on the rectangle shape, holding down the Command key, and clicking once on my text layer. This will select only the layers that I need. I'll make sure that I'm on the arrow tool, and then once again clicking my alignment icons here. For my bottom text, I'm going to draw out a new rectangle, and I'm going to turn off the stroke and just leave the fill as is. I'm going to duplicate this texture layer by selecting it and hitting Command J. And next, I'm going to drag it down right to on top of my new shape layer. And then again, once again, putting my cursor right in between these two layers, holding down the Option key and clicking once. So I want to change the color of my texture layer here just for that extra visual interest. So with my texture layer selected, I'm going to add a new adjustment layer. And I'm going to select Hue and Saturation. Next, I want to click on this little icon here to make sure that it is masked to my shape layer. I'll click on Colorize, and then I can move the adjuster sliders around to make any modifications to the color that I need. Once I have the colors that I like, I'll do some final adjustments and make sure that my elements are aligned. So we'll zoom back out. Let's turn off our reference layer. And let's export this. On this lower third, I've already dropped in my reference image, and we're going to make some changes that are going to be more freestyle and a lot more organic. I've already downloaded this file from FreePick, and I will drop in a link to the description field. This is just some torn paper elements that I thought would look really nice to give that organic feel. I'm going to select my wand tool and then select this one particular shape here that I'm going to use. But I'm going to make a quick modification and just go under Select, Modify, and Contract. I'm going to put in 3 pixels and say OK. This way, I don't get any of the extra little artifacts that are around the edge. So with this selected, I'm going to hit Command-C to copy. Go over here to my canvas and hit Command-V to paste. Next, I'm going to transform this image and reposition. So I'm going to hit Command-T to transform, right-click, and select 180, and that'll automatically rotate my image for me. I'll press Return to commit the changes, reposition, and transform again to scale it down a little bit. Next, I'm going to drop in a text layer and reposition. I'm going to make some quick changes to my paper layer. So let's rename this layer to Paper. And then I'm going to double-click on it and select Color Overlay. Here I can make any color selection that I want to, but I'm going to go for a little bit of a light tan color. Next, I'm going to go to Inner Shadow, and I'm going to make sure that this is set at normal, this is set at white, and say OK. If I zoom in, it gives me that little bit of an edge applied here to the top. Next, I'm going to add a brand new layer. I'm going to go over here to my color palette and select a color. Select my brush tool, and then I'm going to right click on my canvas, and I can look for any of the brushes that I have. If you don't have any brushes, I can link to some places where you can download some special brushes, but I'm going to select a brush and just freestyle some elements here onto my canvas. I'll create a new layer and essentially repeat the steps. Now, you can certainly spend a little bit more time dialing these in and making the adjustments that you need. But for right now, you can get a pretty good idea of what you can do. These are all on their own separate layer, so I can move these around and turn them on and off as I need to. Just as before, we'll turn off our reference image and then save this out. And for our last lower third, I've already got my basic elements loaded here, and I've also have a blurry background image that I'm going to use for my background shape. We'll do the same as we did before, and I'm going to hit Command T to transform, scale this up, hit return to commit my changes, and then again put my cursor in between the two layers, hit the Option key and click once, and this is now masked to my shape layer. So let's drop in some text elements. For the social icons, I've already downloaded a vector file, and I'll put a link to this file in the description below as well. I'll simply just copy and paste these elements into my Photoshop document. Now that I have the social icons in, I'm just going to change the layer names. I'll double-click on the layer, add a color overlay, and click OK. Next, I'll make sure that my elements are aligned to the middle, so hitting the Command key and then selecting the layers that I need, and then making sure that I'm on the arrow tool, I'll hit Middle Align. I can move around the elements as I need to. By holding down the Shift key, this will constrain the movement of these elements to either the X or Y axis. I'll make some final adjustments and then prepare my image to save. With all of our images, we can add them to any video project that we want and use them as a full screen overlay. You can experiment and make changes as you need to for your lower thirds. Your lower thirds can be used for titles, song lyrics, and even social tags.
Staying organized inside of Photoshop is really crucial to your whole design workflow. One of the biggest challenges that I've seen for people is trying to figure out coordinating colors. Now, this leads me to my bonus section, where I actually have two resources to share with you. Resource number one is Adobe Color. This is a great website tool for you to explore and find color combinations that you can use in your projects. I'll drop a link below in the description. The second resource that I have is another link in the description where you can download these Photoshop files to help you get started. Check out my other how-to video tutorials. I'll see you in the next video.